हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। सो इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द ईसीजी फाइंडिंग्स इन वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ एरिथमियाज। सो फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द वुल्फ पार्किंसन वाइट सिंड्रोम WPW। सो बेसिकली इन दिस व्हाट इज़ द फाइंडिंग, सो इन दिस वी फाइंड दैट द PR इंटरवल और वी कैन से PQ इंटरवल। सो PR इंटरवल विल डिक्रीज एंड वी सी द डेल्टा वेव इन दिस। सो for this wolf parkinson white syndrome we have two finding, that is delta wave is seen, that is most probably we always see the delta wave in ecg and pr interval is decreased. And how it looks in the ecg, it looks like that suppose this one is a p wave, then we have like this slant. This is the P wave and then we have this type of slant and then we have like this. This finding we see in the ECG of Wolf Parkinson White syndrome. And this slanting, this one which we see here is the delta wave. Please remember it. This one is the delta wave. And for extra point for Wolf Parkinson syndrome white syndrome, the drug of choice which we give is the oral flecainide is the drug of choice. And for this the treatment of choice is radio frequency ablation. So this all is the finding of the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome with their drug of choice and the treatment of choice. Now let's see in the ECG. So here is the ECG of the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome. So here we see that this is a slanting. So this is a slanting. So it means that there is slanting between the P and R wave and there is absence of Q wave. So in this we see the Q wave is absent. So Q wave is absent in the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome and there is PR interval is decreased because Q wave is not there. And from the P wave like this, so this is the normal Q, R and then S. So here this one portion is absent. Instead of absent, there is slanting like this. It is raising like this. So this is the delta wave. That's why the PR interval is decreased in the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome. Let's find it on the another ECG. So here in this ECG, as we see here, so in this we find the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome. So here as I zoom it, so you see that there is slanting. In this also we see slanting. This is a delta wave. Here also delta wave. So these all are the delta wave. These all were the delta wave. So here we see the delta wave and PR interval is reduced and Q wave is absent. So these three findings we see in the Wolf Parkinson White syndrome. The first finding is the PR interval reduced, there is delta wave and Q wave is absent. So these three were the finding for Wolf Parkinson White syndrome, how we can identify in the ECG. Now the second one, that is the AV block. So for the AV block, what we see, so in the AV block, as we all know, there were first degree heart block, second degree heart block and third degree heart block. So for the first degree heart block, what we see in the first degree heart block, there is no absence of any wave. Instead of absence, we see that the PR interval is more than 200 millisecond. PR interval is more than 200 millisecond. This is the only finding for the first degree heart block and we see constant. So it is constant. So let's see on the ECG. So this is the ECG. As we know that here it is the P wave. This is the P wave. And here this is the R and this one is the S wave. So as we see, this interval is in the normal. It is between the 0.12 and 0.08 to 0.12. But here it is more than that. So it is more than 200 millisecond. It is more than 200 millisecond. So this is represent that there is a prime first degree heart block. This shows it is a first degree heart block. And we did not see any absence of wave in this. All everything is normal. Q, R, R, S, T, P, QRST P. Everything is normal. There is no absence of any wave. But we see that the PR interval is more than 200 millisecond. PR interval is more than 200 millisecond. This is the only finding for the first degree heart block. Now let's move to the second degree heart block. For the second degree heart block, we all know that it is two types. That is Mobius type 1 and Mobius type 2. Mobius type 1 and the other one is the Mobius type 2 heart block. So for the Mobius type 1, what we have to see that in the Mobius type 1, we see that there is a missed beat. And whenever there is a missed beat, we have to check before that beat. Before and after that, we have to check the PR interval. We have to check the PR interval and we find that the PR interval is constantly increasing. Means that PR interval is not same on both sides. Before that missed beat and after that missed beat. Let's see it on the ECG. So suppose this is a ECG of the person. So here what we see that this is a PQRS T. And again there is P, means there is absence of one beat. So here it is absence of one beat and we have to check, after that we have to check the PR interval. So here this is the PR interval and here also this one is the PR interval. So if we want to check this distance, we find that this distance and this distance, it's not constant. It is more. Here it is more and here it is less. So this is not constant. So this is the Mobius type 1. This is a Mobius type 1 heart block. And Mobius type 1 heart block. So here it is the PR interval is not constant. It is increasing. This is Mobius type 1. And in the Mobius type 2. So here I am writing the Mobius type 2 heart block. So Mobius type 2, that is a secondary heart block. So in the Mobius type 2, we find that the PR interval is constant. When we check before and after the missed beat, the PR interval is constant in this. And we also see the missed beat in this. Missed beat is seen both in type 1 Mobius and type 2 Mobius. But what is the difference? So this is the difference, that in Mobius type 2, PR is constant. While in the Mobius type 1, the PR interval is increasing. So here in the ECG, as we see here, so this is a QRS complex, then T, then P, then again P, means here it is absent. So if we want to check the PR interval, means this one interval and this one interval, so it is constant. So it is constant, it means the PR interval is constant before and after the missed beat. So this is the finding for the Mobius type 2 heart block. So now move to the third degree heart block. So in the third degree heart block, it means that there is complete heart block, means atria is contracted without the SA node. So it atria and ventricles both are contracted separately. So if they both are contracting separately, it means in this we did not find the PP interval and RR interval equal. In this we did not find the PP interval and RR interval equal, so here it is unequal. So this is the finding for the third degree heart block, that PP and RR interval is not same, they are different. And the other name for third degree heart block is the Stokes-Adams syndrome. Please remember it, Stokes-Adams syndrome is the other name for the third degree heart block. And in this ECG, how we identify that they are separately. So let's see. So as we see here in this image, this is P, R, S, T, then T, then here is P, P, then again here is P, again here is P, means this is the PP interval and this one is the R interval. So if we match them, means PP interval and RR interval, they are not equal. So PP and RR interval is not equal in this. So this is the finding of the third degree heart block. This is the finding of third degree heart block. Now let's move to the other type of arrhythmia. So in the other type of arrhythmia, we have to see the atrial fibrillation. We have to see the atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter. So in the atrial fibrillation, what is the finding? First, please remember it, that in the atrial fibrillation, we find P wave is absent. In this, P wave is absent in atrial fibrillation. And the other finding is that the RR is irregular, means they are irregular. RR interval is irregular. They are not constant. And QRS complex is either decreased or either it is normally. But for atrial fibrillation, we find the RR interval is irregular. So now in this image, as we see, P wave is absent. So I am not drawing any P wave. So this is the T. After that, RS complex. Then after that, RS complex. And then again T wave. And then again RS complex. And then again T wave. And then after that, again RS complex. And then again T, and like this. So in this, as we see, the RR interval, it is not equal. I am not drawing it equally, means the RR interval is irregular. So in the atrial fibrillation, RR interval is irregular and the P wave is absent. This is the most finding of the atrial fibrillation. Please remember it. And on the ECG, as I show you here, so in this, as we see here, that this is the RS complex, this one is RS, this one is QRX complex. But here we see this distance, as we see here, so this distance is not equal. It is irregular distance. So this distance is irregular. So, and P wave is also absent here. So this is the finding for the atrial fibrillation. Please remember it. Atrial fibrillation, irregular RR interval is there. And for the atrial flutter, so here I am telling you about the atrial flutter. So in the atrial flutter, what we see? So in the atrial flutter, we have to check in the lead 2, lead 3 and AVF. We have to find a sawtooth pattern. Please remember it. Sawtooth pattern is seen in lead 2, 3 and AVF. Please remember it. It is most important that sawtooth pattern is seen in atrial flutter. How sawtooth pattern look? It looks like this. But it is regular, you know. This one is regular. So RR interval is regular in atrial flutter, but it shows the sawtooth pattern. Please remember it. Sawtooth pattern is seen in atrial flutter and it shows the RR interval regular. So now here in this ECG, what we see, that this R, this R, this R. So this one interval is regular here, and we see this is a sawtooth pattern. It's look like a sawtooth pattern. So this is a sawtooth pattern which is seen in the atrial flutter. So these were the findings for the atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter. In atrial fibrillation, we see RR interval irregular, while in the atrial flutter, we see RR interval is regular. Now let's move to the other one, that is the PSVT, that is the PSVT, paroxysmal supraventricular tachycardia. Supraventricular tachycardia, if it is a ventricle or supraventricle. So in this PSVT, what we find a narrow QRS complex. Narrow QRS complex, please remember it. It is most important. In this we find narrow QRS complex, and also we see the ST segment is depressed. We see ST segment depression in this, and the RR interval is regular and it is decreased. Regular and decreased, and P and T wave is merged, means sometime we find both separately and sometime P and T wave is merged. So let's find in the ECG these findings, that is narrow QRS, ST segment depression, RR regular or decrease, and PT wave is merged. So in this, as we see here, there is only one wave, means it is merged of P and T wave. After QRS complex, T wave come, and after that P wave come. But here we see that P and T wave is merged. So merged P and T wave, okay. And here we see a depression in the ST segment. We see a depression also. So this one is a depression. So this one is a depression here, as we see. So it is a depression of ST segment. And also we see the narrow QRX complex. This is a complex is narrow. So QRS complex is narrow. So these three findings for the PSVT, that is narrow QRS complex, ST segment depression, and PT wave is merged. So these were the finding of the PSVT. After PSVT, let's move to the ventricle tachycardia. So in the ventricle tachycardia, what we see? So first we remember the marking of the ventricle tachycardia. In this we find the heart rate is more than 100 per minute, and as we all know, we have to check the heart rate by seeing the lead 2, and we have to check the box and divided it by 300. So in this we see the heart rate is more than 100 per minute, and we find the Joseph sign in this. We find the Joseph sign in this, and we find a capture beat is there. We find a capture beat is also in that. And ventricle tachycardia is of two types. That is the monomorphic ventricle tachycardia, monomorphic or polymorphic. These were two types. Ventricle tachycardia is of two types, monomorphic or polymorphic. In the monomorphic, we find that chair-like sign. Suppose this is a chair-like sign. So it is a Joseph sign. So it is a Josephson sign. So it is a Josephson sign. While in the polymorphic ventricle tachycardia, we see waves like they are increasing like this, and then they are again decreasing. So in the monomorphic, all were we find our first one is the Josephson sign, and also we see that all were in the same line. All were in the same line, and then we see one premature beat, one mature beat, and after that again like this. So this is finding we see in the monomorphic, and in polymorphic we see like increasing and decreasing. So here in this image, what we see, so in this image we all see that the we see a polymorphic in this. We see a polymorphic ventricle tachycardia. So in polymorphic, as I told you, first the waves were decreasing, then increasing, and then they again decreasing, and then again increasing like this, and then they again decreasing. So this is a finding for the polymorphic ventricle tachycardia. They are increasing, then decreasing, then again increasing, then decreasing. So increasing, decreasing like this. This is a polymorphic ventricle tachycardia. While for the monomorphic, let's see in this image. So this is a monomorphic ventricle tachycardia. How we can identify? We see a Josephson sign is there, like a chair. We see a like a chair sign is there, and also these were in the constant form. Like see here, it is a constant form. So that's why it is a monomorphic. Ventricle tachycardia. So it is a monomorphic ventricle tachycardia. Now the next one is the ventricle fibrillation. So in the ventricle fibrillation, what we see? So for the ventricle fibrillation, we did not see anything. We just see like this. So this one is seen in the ventricle fibrillation. As we see here in this image, we see like this one. So this is a ventricle fibrillation. After this, let's move to the left bundle branch block and right bundle branch block. So here I'm going to tell you about the first one is the right bundle branch block. After that, right bundle branch block. So in the right bundle branch block, so for our easy purpose, we have to remember the marrow, M-A-R-R-O-W. First letter is M, last letter is W. Now how we can remember it? Means in the lead V1 and V2, we see the, in lead V1 and V2, we see the M shape, that is the tall R wave is seen. While in the lead V5 and V6, we see the deep S wave. This is the purpose for remembrance of marrow. As M comes on the first letter, means V1 and V2, we see tall R wave because R comes above and S comes downward. So if M is there, means lead V1, V2, there is large tall R wave, and in deep S wave we find the V5 and V6. So this is the finding of the right bundle branch block. Now let's see on to the lead. So this is a V1, V2, and V1, V2, I told you we find a M, means M VC. So here, as we see, this is a M. This is a M shape. So in this, this is a M shape, means this is a marrow shape, means we find in this a tall R wave in V1 and V2. It resembles M, while in the V5 and V6, we see a deep S wave. We have to see deep S wave here. So here it is not so clear. So deep S wave is seen like this one. So deep S wave is seen here. So for the V1 and V2, we can identify that it is shows us the M shape. That's why it is a right bundle branch block. It is a right bundle branch block. Now let's move to the left bundle branch block. So left bundle branch block. So what is the finding of left bundle branch block? So in the left bundle branch block, please remember it. For this, we have to remember the William. We have to remember William. As W letter first comes and M letter last comes, it means that in this or vice versa to the right bundle branch block, in here we see the deep S wave, deep S wave in V1, V2, while tall R wave in V5 and V6, because above side we have R wave and downside we have S wave, so W resembles the deep S wave in V1 and V2. Now let's find it. So it here, as we see here, this is a W, this is a W, something like this is C, like this, as we see here. So this is a deep S wave in V1 and V2. Here also we see deep S wave in V1 and V2. While as we see in the V5 and V6, we see a M letter. We see M letter. So this is a tall R wave in V5 and V6. So please remember it. These were the difference between the right bundle branch block and left bundle branch block. How we can identify? So for the right bundle branch block, here I am telling you again, for the right bundle branch block and left bundle branch block, for left, please remember the William. Please remember it, William. And for the right bundle branch block, please remember marrow. So as in the first letter M comes and the last letter W comes, so M means that there is tall R wave in V1 and V2, and deep S wave in V5 and V6. While for the left bundle branch block, W comes and M last, so means in V1 and V2 we find the deep S wave, while in the V5 and V6 we find the tall R wave. We find tall R wave. So this is the finding of the right bundle branch block and left bundle block. Again on the ECG, as you saw, in V1 we see the W shape, and V5, V6 we find M, means William is there, means it is left bundle branch block. While for the right bundle branch block, we see in the V1, V2 M is there, while in the V5, V6 we see S is there, means W is there. So it is a marrow. It is a right bundle branch block. So that's all about the arrhythmia findings on the ECG. I hope you get benefit of this video. Thank you. Bye-bye, guys.